So basically, incision is made with a scalpel. In OR or in OT, the surgeon holds the scalpel with the blade being firmly pressed down at the right angle to the skin, like this. Can you see here? Like this. And then it is gently drawn across the skin in a desired direction to create a clean incision. There should not be any hesitation cut. It should be clean incision. And one should use the belly of the blade rather than the tip of the blade to make the incision. So blades for skin incision should be curved like this. So a skin incision blade should be curved like this. While for arteriotomy, like you have to make a hole in the artery for making AV fistula, or in the vein for making AV fistula, or some other vascular procedure, or even for drain site insertion, the blades with sharp tip should be used like this. So there are various numbering of the blades based on this structure, whether they are sharp tip, whether this belly and curvature is larger. So this the sharp tip is 11 number blade. So which is basically used for arteriotomy and for insertion of the drains. While this is a 15 number blade, which is used for minor surgical procedure like lipoma excision and small procedures. This and this are the major blades which we use for major surgery like laparotomy. We usually use 22 or 23 number of the blade. So in our setup, we are using 22 blades, and this blade should never be held by hand directly. It should be incorporated in the BP handle. There are grooves here to incorporate the blade in it. And then once the blade and BP handle is assembled, then you have to make the incision. So when planning a skin incision, you must consider four factors, which are skin tension line, Langer's line. Basically, there are they represent the orientation of dermal collagen fibers. There are lines which go all over the body, and they represent the orientation of the dermal collagen fibers. And any incision which is parallel to these fibers result in better scar. Like say, if you are excising something in pectoral region, if you give a scar like this, then it will heal better. But if you give a scar like this, then all the dermal collagen fiber will be cut at right angle, and the resulting scar will be poor. So one should always keep Langer's line, which are also known as skin tension line, in view. So this is the posterior and this is the anterior line. And one should also consider anatomical structures. And incision should avoid bony prominences. Like say, you want to give incision for hernia, then you should give incision like this rather than incorporating near the ASIS. And it should be crossing skin creases if possible, and one should take into consideration of underlying structure such as nerve and vessel, and they should not be exposed. Like one make the inguinal hernia incision in the groin crease so that it remain hidden in the natural skin creases. Like the thyroid incision is also made in the natural crease of the neck so that it is hidden into the natural creases, and one should not expose the underlying nerve or vessel lying beneath. And one should also consider the cosmetic factor. One should always strive for making an incision which will result in a better cosmesis rather than a poor cosmesis. And the most important factor is adequate access to the procedure. Access is very important. Sometimes novice surgeon tend to make a smaller incision for a cosmesis, and then they tend to make more complication. So cosmesis is secondary as compared to the safety and access to the surgery being done. So like if you are doing a hernia surgery, the initial learning curve, you should try to make a slightly larger incision to gain a proper access to see the structures properly rather than just focusing on the cosmetic factors. So there is an entity known as dog ears. Once it may remain at the corner of the elliptical incision despite care taken during formation and closure of the elliptical wound. What happens is once you close the elliptical wound, there is kind of heaping of the skin which is known as dog ear at the corner, which give a poor cosmetic scar. So it is advisable to pick the dog ear with the skin hook, and it should be excised. So you should pick it with the skin hook and then excise in a proper manner and then closes primarily like this. So now coming to abdominal incisions. So all abdominal incisions should be planned before surgery. So it is not like that if you are planning for a cystogastrostomy or open cholecystectomy that you will plan in the OR. You have to plan the incision preoperatively, and it should be carried deeper to through the subcutaneous tissue. And depending on site of the incision, the muscle layer should be divided or split. Like in appendectomy, there are certain incisions like Lange incision, which is muscle splitting. So it will just you will just split the muscle rather than cutting it. While in Rutherford-Morris incision, you will cut the muscle incision. So muscle splitting incision should be preferred. So in the abdomen, once you reach the peritoneum, this should be picked between the two clips, two artery or two clips, and it should be incised gently so that you should not damage the underlying organ. And one should open the abdomen with closure in mind. So there is a surgical aphorism that a good opening is half closure done. If you open the abdomen in a proper manner, then it is considered half closure done. So there is a concept of mass closure of the abdominal wall, and which is advocated by using a larger bite in a short step in a closure technique using a non-absorbable suture, either nylon or polypropylene, or very slow absorbable sutures like PDS, polydexanone sutures. And for abdominal wall closure, there is a Jenkins rule which says that if the abdominal length is X, the abdominal wound length is X, then at least you should require 4x length of the suture to close it to minimize the risk of abdominal dehiscence and later incisional hernia. This is also known as Jenkins rule. So these are the various abdominal incision. This is a midline laparotomy incision. The two number is for open cholecystectomy, the caucus incision. And this is the horizontal incision. This is the thoracoabdominal incision. And this one is paramedial incision. This one is incision for appendectomy, that is gridiron incision. McBurney's gridiron incision. This is incision for inguinal hernia. So inguinal incision. This is incision for lower segment caesarean section, which is known as fenestial incision. And this is McEverdy incision, sometimes used for femoral hernia. And this one is Rutherford-Morris incision.